Ready for your quiz? Sure, why not? Alright, time for the first question. Which of the following products is a palette wet?
What the fuck?
What the heck's a palette? It's one of those things that reads the same forward and backwards, right? Think you can handle this, Nagi? You need words. Which of the following products is a palette? I don't know. This one. 55. 55 times 55. I have no idea. Which breed of dog has a bronze statue in front of Shiba? I think it's a Shiba. What's an Akita? Okay, last question. How the heck should I know? I don't live in Tokyo.
Nanto.
Fine. What the heck's Akita? I've literally never heard of that type of dog. Yeah, we won by the power of multiple choice. Always answer C. Eesh. Well, that was the most pleasant diversion. We literally just pressed things by random, and then we won. Let's return to more important matters.
Yeah.
Dang, Senpai, you smoked that guy. That's right. She sure knows her stuff, even though she answered randomly. Yeesh. I guess he, went off somewhere.
Later.
This is sure. You're not gonna get me this time, I knew your tricks. Except when you actually got me. Took less damage than I think we usually do, though. Some people say that I battled too much, I say not enough. It doesn't matter anyways, because I cut most of it out. And then dead. Wait, there's a shark there I didn't even notice. Fine, I'll retry. Retry, then kill the thing. Because killing things. Yeah, this should be easy, because I don't get hit by these anyways. There we go. So I have no idea how I got hit, even though I only got hit like once. And I still got an A ring! For some reason.
A few minutes later.
I agree to lend a helping hand. Oh, thank you! Just listen to the poor guy. Did I even cut his curry? Was cultural what? 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 Can I get a better, can I get a more accurate translation, team? Because, that term is exclusively used in America. I'm pretty sure that's not a thing that exists in Japan. Huh? Four kids? Four kids? You wanna explain yourselves? You! I just decided I'm not gonna help you anymore because you're an idiot.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, ride up, cowboy!
Oh, I forgot. You're broken. I don't wanna play with you anymore.
What the fuck?
Later.
Yōkoso.
Konikoniye.
What the heck? Was there always this? Wait, did I actually come here before? I don't think I did.
これはどうだい?
おすすめですわ?
Okay, words. That's some real, twin energy.
スキャンするぞ.
Maybe it's like a local shop thing and not a chain thing. Cause it'd be really weird if it was a chain thing. And that there are like creepy twins in every single shop. I like this shop better. It actually has the stat that matters. Now it's Scramble Crossing. Let's head over to a dock. Dog, doggy, doggy, doggy. Sign. There we go. Literally every single puzzle involves this dog.
Rindo-dono.
Yes, Rindo-dono. Not Lord Rindo, like the text makes you believe. No, that is inaccurate. This appears to be quite literally a sign from Roji.
Disney.
Sure does. Looks like some kind of quiz. The answer is C! Answer C. Then we'll get a super awesome fun time. Roji sure got a lot of time on his hands for a guy who's in trouble or whatever. Okay, the question is, which of the following isn't on the menu at Hachiko Cafe? Is it C? I bet it's C. Actually, it's 7. Darn it, so close. Easy peasy, just look it up.
Kensoku.
The menu isn't on their site. For some reason. Seems like a really convenient one, attracting customers. Okay then, which one is it? Iced coffee, ice cream float, milk tea. I don't think they serve tea here. I don't think they serve milk tea.
おそらく.
While I'm not wholly certain, I believe that is correct. Oh yeah, I just remembered. I tried to order that once, but they told me they didn't have it. Should have used that reminder power of yours on yourself. Come on, that would never work. Unless. Anyway, I'm putting that down as our answer. And the results? Got it. Says one of the 9. Beautiful, good work, team, but mostly Rindo. Okay, that's one down. I have no idea how I'm gonna find the other ones, but you'll know. Pretend that I'm rapping. Really? I haven't actually won here yet. Okay. Sup, dude? Can you let us through? Sure thing, after you do what I say, of course. My mission for you is... It's a dolphin. To defeat these noise. Good luck. A bunch of last place losers like you are gonna need it.
10 seconds later.
Not bad for a bunch of noobs. While clear, head on through. Thunder and lightning. Summon bolts of lightning to strike a target and surrounding enemies. Chances slightly shocking the enemy. Because don't need thunder that badly. Especially because we still... Actually, I don't think we won here yet. Tower Record Shibuya. Where is this? And more importantly, what can I kick? What butts can I kick? Eh! Good going, Twisters! Keep it up! Hmm? Maybe I'm imagining things. Maybe that giant rabbit right in front of me is just in my imagination. Wouldn't that be something? It's a blue thing. Come here, blue thing.
Still nothing! You got nothing!
Huh. Another sticker there, but let's head to the shop first. Guagua eggs. Guava. Vigila, ew! Drunk. You know, actually, green smoothies isn't actually half bad. I've had some before, it's actually pretty good. This looks disgusting though. What the heck? Like, $7 for avocados? Sheesh. This must be like California or something. Alright, I forgot to, look at the ugly green thing that no one wants to eat.
Are?
There's another one of Roji's barcodes. Looks like a quiz.
Another one?
Yeah. Yeah, let's answer C again. I mean, that worked last time. Ugly butt seat.
Who exactly is this Ryoji character, pray tell? I'm entirely unfamiliar.
All we know is he's some sort of a jack of all trades. And that tracking him down is a huge pain in our asses. That we're doing for some reason. Yes, that much is readily transparent. Transparent, apparent, same word, English. What's not readily apparent is why we're doing this? Exactly. Like, how come Suzukichi wants us to lend this guy a hand so bad? Why doesn't he help himself? Kinda weird, right? It's exactly what I was wondering. Kinda. We should probably focus on this... whatever it is. Agabagagut-G. That's right, the answer is obviously 3, because that's what C is.
It appears to be a code of some sort kind.
Akadaga. The answer is Akadaga. Obviously. If A equals 1 and C equals 3 and D equals 4, then G equals 11. Obviously the correct answer is 7, because that's answer C. If you follow the pattern, the answer should be 7.
Nande?
Wait, how do you know? It's because it was the C answer C. Obviously, dum-dum. Just answer C, and then you'll pass. Well? I'm pretty sure I'm right, but what if I'm not? Hang on a second. Hey, Swallow, can you help me with, social media texts?
Sure, what's up?
Look at this. The answer is 7, right?
Give me a sec. Makes sense to me. Looks like a cipher based on alphabetical order. Also, did you answer C? The answer is always C.
Yeah, I answered C.
Alright then, this is correct.
That's what I thought. Am I really correct? I didn't even bother solving the puzzle, I just answered C.
Okay, cool, thanks game.
Thanks.
Nippa, is this a part of the game you're playing?
Yeah, I just wanted to make sure I got it right. I didn't even bother trying to solve it, I just answered C.
Each letter gets a number based on its place in the alphabet. Well, I kinda got that, but I didn't bother trying to figure out what number G was. So I just guessed 7 because that was the third answer.
Ooh.
I see. Huh? That's right. That's why you should always answer C. I know, right? A is B, A is C, C is 7, and G is 748. Numbers. Yeah, that makes sense. I think I get it now. You didn't even bother reading that word bubble. That's because I hate math. Makes sense to me. 7 was right. One of the digits is 3. You call that a clue? Come on, we solved your damn riddle. At least you could do is give us a real answer. Actually, they did. They said that the answer was C. Well, how the heck is that supposed to help us? I don't know.
Dana?
Yoji isn't making this easy for us. He's a real jackass of all trades, that's for sure. Gee, thanks, Ryoji, for, giving us the answer is C. Look at the fork of jogging! Down a kill smoothie and then do yoga. I love exercise. I exercise till the day I die. Van Gogh is pretty popular these days. I guess I'll download it, even though I have no idea what it was. That's how they get ya. Imagine if it's like, I don't know, spyware or something.
I wonder if I can get my hands on that new death march.
March, yes, definitely March. And not some other month.
I guess I'm the coolest kitchen gadget, an orange peeler. How could I pass that up?
Yes. The revolutionary gadget that will change the world, an orange peeler. What is over here? No music, no life. What the heck? I wanted to shop. I wanted to shop and it made me look at a stupid sticker. Found a barcode. I thought we were going inside the shop. Yeah, that's what I thought too, but no, apparently the game wanted us to look at the sticker. Scan it, dude. What did it say? It says, you're not allowed to go to the shop unless if you look at the sticker first. Yeah, makes sense to me. It says something. Alright. It just says something? Yep, just said something. Like, not actual something, I mean the actual word. Yes, yep, something. You can see it, because it's on the text bubble right now.
Oh yeah?
It is surprisingly simple. It's a no-brainer. We all know the answer, or at least, we should. Is it C? I'm pretty sure it's C. What's the name of the handyman you're trying to reach? We're trying to reach number C. Ryoji, duh.
So, so.
Well, that sounds right to me, but is it number C? Maybe. Alright, cool. Okay, your answer is Ryoji. Bingo, we're hard-earned clues, one of the digits 7. Twin have been unspeakably embarrassing to forget his name of all things. I actually kind of want to see what happens if we answer the wrong thing now.
Disney.
Yeah, it'd be pretty awkward if he found out. Man, we're so good at finding clues. We should be detectives and have a talking dog. By the way, let's split up.
That sounds like a perfect idea.
Alrighty, Twisters, we got ourselves a full 6-digit set, even though I wanted to enter the shop.
What?
I know it. Now I call Ryoji from the phone booth by Tower Records.
Let us be on our way, quickly.
Right. Actually, what is even the order? We got money. Where did this money come from? I have no idea. Oh, someone's calling me. Incoming.
Gokigenyo.
Greetings. Shibuya. I don't know if this is my voice, so I'm just doing this one because I think this is what I voiced him the last time. This is your Game Master Shiba speaking. Hope you're hungry for more on this day 4. Cover some red hot news for you. Set phasers too. Full power.
I just can't do it, Captain. I don't have the power.
One of our teams has already blazed through today's mission. The game's going on like normal without us. This detour better earn us some serious points. Watch it basically earn us less points than what would have happened if we'd actually do the quest mission thing. Gee, thanks. He also, we're just trusting him to give us points, even though he's clearly a shady dude. Never trust the rabbit. Also, he's not even going and earning the points either, because he's just literally just following us.
Later.
And it's time for some electric set. Okay, this is actually pretty cool.
I have no idea what to do it though.
Okay, electric thing is actually pretty cool. Let's AoE damage. Too bad I don't know how to use it. Yeah, I did a thing! What that thing was, I have no idea.
A few minutes later.
The Alichon, a pin reminiscent of a transient world, exchange it for items at a certain shop. Yeah, these pins keep reminding me of a dream drop distance. Specifically the world that never was. I don't know, this gives me the world that never was. Specifically the level of dream drop distance. I think the one where you play as Sora. Reminds me of that. With a really tall building.
Meanwhile, at the Krusty Krab.
What the heck is this? What? Do people actually eat alligators? Well, it's Australia, man. I guess anything goes. Is the flower on its head edible? Sauce directly from Australia. Those roasted critters, rich in protein and low in calories. Some lacking its texture of chicken. The true enthusiasts know nothing compares to the fresh alligator.
Dang.
Look at its stats though. Attack 7. Who is brave enough to try this? Fret? No? Wow. Dang. Someone doesn't like, I don't know, experimenting with foods? Or trying new things? I don't know. Do people actually eat this? I like, my initial gut reaction is no, but then again, it is Australia, so who knows. Let's eat the gator! That's a lot of stats. That's a whole lot of stats. It's 80 bucks for a gator. For a whole gator. Including the head and the teeth. That's what a gator's worth. It's 80 bucks. What is kind of funny is the amount of food that 4 teenagers eat. It was basically within a span of one day, they've eaten like, I don't know, 10 meals? Oh dang, there's an actual love triangle here. Hirofumi Itoguchi. Veggie Lovers manager, a veteran regular at Veggie Lovers, hit it off with the owner, quit his job, and got hired as a branch manager.
He and his girlfriend, Sumire Chiba, have been living together for 5 years, but their relationship has reached a standstill due to him being weaker than weak. Willed. Than wilted lettuce. Willed lettuce. Yes. Sumire Chiba, her simple and reserved exterior, belies the fashion-sensitive soul that reads Eiji Oji's blogs on the daily. She hates attention and prefers to keep her position as a Tin Pin Slasher's leader a secret. Is it like the Tin Pin thing back in this game? Maybe. Mitsuhide Tojo, soft-spoken, earnest divorcee in his 50s as he couldn't deal with his temperamental wife anymore and called it quits last year. He wasn't eager to remarry, but his charmingly reserved co-worker Sumire Chiba caught his eye. Despite their age difference, he is courageously working up the courage to confess his feelings. Yep, love triangle. Right here. I mean, just look at him. His entire face screams, cuck. Am I allowed to say that word on YouTube? Maybe, who knows. Who's this dude standing in front of the telephone like that?
I think he's Superman.
Yeah, he's probably Superman. Superman on fire, Superman angry.
I think this is our phone booth.
And a suspicious looking man is standing in our way. You think he's Superman?
Yeah, probably. I mean, who else is stupid enough to use a telephone booth that no one actually uses these days? Also, you can see right through it. How the heck is Superman supposed to change his clothes whenever you can just literally just look through the window? Dude has little helper written all over him.
Yeah, and he's giving off some seriously bad vibes. One must venture to say he appears almost mournful.
I think this is the Snyder Cut. Is this Snyder Justice League?
Certainly! It most definitely is the Snyder Cut. I don't know. I don't pay attention to those types of movies. Too depressing. I did like the Snyder Cut though, but I didn't watch the original Justice League. Or Batman vs. Superman. At all.